touching another person's life. Contributed by Jean M. Lally. One day a teacher asked her students to list the names of the other students in the room on two sheets of paper, leaving a space between each name. Then she told them to think of the nicest thing they could say about each of their classmates and write it down. It took the remainder of the class period to finish their assignment, and as the students left the room, each one handed in the papers. That Saturday, the teacher wrote down the name of each student on a separate sheet of paper, and listed what everyone else had said about that individual. On Monday she gave each student his or her list. Before long, the entire class was smiling. "Really," she heard whispered. "I never knew that I meant anything to anyone, and, I didn't know others liked me so much," were most of the comments. No one ever mentioned those papers in class again. She never knew if they discussed them after class or with their parents, but it didn't matter. It had accomplished its purpose. The students were happy with themselves and one another. That group of students moved on. Several years later, one of the students was killed in Vietnam and his teacher attended the funeral. She had never seen a serviceman in a military coffin before. He looked so handsome, so mature, sure. The church was packed with his friends. One by one those who loved him took a last walk by the coffin. The teacher was the last in line. As she stood there, one of the soldiers who acted as a pallbearer came up to her. "Were you Mark's math teacher?" he asked. She nodded, "Yes." Then he said, "Mark talked a lot about you." After the funeral, most of Mark's former classmates attended a luncheon in his honor. Mark's mother and father were there, and obviously waiting to speak with his teacher. "We want to show you something," his father said, taking a wallet out of his pocket. "They found this on Mark when killed. We thought you might recognize it." Opening the billfold, he carefully removed two worn pieces of notebook paper that had obviously been taped, folded, and refolded many times. The teacher knew without looking that the papers were the ones on which she had listed all the good things each of Mark's classmates had said about him. "Thank you so much for doing that," Mark's mother said. As you can see, Mark treasured it. All of Mark's former classmates started to gather round. Charlie smiled rather sheepishly and said, "I still have my list. It's in the top drawer of my desk at home." Chuck's wife said, "Chuck asked me to put his in our wedding album." "I have mine too," Marilyn said. "It's in my diary." Then Vicky, another classmate, reached into her pocketbook, took out her wallet and showed her worn and frazzled list to the group. "I carry this with me at all times," Vicky said, and without batting an eyelash, she continued, "I think we all saved our lists." That's when the teacher finally sat down and cried. In today's reading we see Jesus reach out and touch a deaf man who also had a speech impediment. Just like our teacher, Jesus had changed this man's life forever. Imagine waking up one day and realizing you couldn't hear a sound. Imagine not being able to communicate, you speak but you are not understood, how could you hold a job? Through Jesus' compassionate touch this man's life was restored and he was again made whole. Each day Jesus' compassionate touch comes into your life, maybe in the form of a teacher challenging you to do something nice for someone else. Maybe a child asking for a hug, or a full spouse giving you a kiss. They are all examples of God's love being transmitted through others, who touch your life in subtle, but meaningful ways. It is now your turn to be God's hands working in our world. Who will you encourage today? Who will you help? Who will you compliment? Who will you reach out and touch in a demonstration of Christ's love today?